Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how you can apply a texture to a curved surface, or in this case, we're going to be doing a cylinder in SketchUp. Alright, so I have a SketchUp file open here, and I've imported a can from the 3D warehouse, and what I want to do is essentially put a label on this part of the can, the cylinder part of it. So I've made a few adjustments just so that this works with the texture that I found online, but I'll explain to you as we go through this what I've done. And this should really help you sort of figure out what is going on. So the first thing that I want to do is I want to import my texture that I want to apply to this can. So I'm going to go to File, Import, and then I want to make sure that I have Image selected. You can also have Texture. For this, I'm just going to have Image though, because I'm going to show you a few different ways. Image will import it as an image into the file, so it's sort of like a 3D object. Texture will just put it in your material library. New match photo is essentially if you're trying to match a photo, it'll give you some perspective lines that you can pick. So I'm gonna choose this. This video is not sponsored by Coca-Cola, but if they want to sponsor me, they can do that. So we're just gonna scale it just really rough. So we have that in there. Now when you import a file like this, an image, it's not editable. So what you want to do is go to explode, and that'll make it a physical object, and then you can regroup it. So what I'm going to do here is hit M to move. I'm going to rotate this, so I'm hitting Q to rotate, and I hit M to move just a second ago. I hit Q to rotate again, and then I'm using the arrow keys to lock to the axes that I want, and so we have this guy. So basically at this point, we want to reverse this. So there's a few different ways that you can do this, and I'm going to show you the first way, and then I'll show you the way that I would do it, just so that you're aware of the different options that you have. So the first way is not going to be ideal, but it may work for what you're doing. So this is a cylinder, so this first thing that we're going to do isn't going to be ideal, but if I explode this and then click on this face here and go down to texture, you can see that this projected is checked. So what that means is that if I take this texture and I apply it to anything else, it will take the current view of this texture and it will project it onto that surface in that direction, if that makes sense. So if I hit B to bring up the paint bucket tool and then hold Alt while I have that paint bucket selected, I can eyedropper my texture and click on the cylinder. And what it does is it projects that onto the surface. And I know that's a little bit confusing what's happening. It's basically like taking this image here and pushing it onto this, whatever I can see here, it's pushing it onto that face. So you get some like weird sort of like things, what's going on here? You know, it doesn't make sense. But if you're just doing like a curved surface, like a flat curved surface, this doesn't work because it's a cylinder. But if you just have like some kind of curved surface that's, I don't want to say on one plane, but it's facing one plane, this is multi-directional, but it's primarily facing one plane, this could be a great option. And I just want to show you really quick, if I rotate this, this doesn't change dynamically, but you can see now that now I see this Coca-Cola. Just to demonstrate how that works a little bit. Okay, so we have this, it's not working. So what we want to do is we want to essentially wrap this texture around the soda can. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to uncheck. You just want to make sure you have that face, this single face selected. I'm going to uncheck projected. And then what I'm going to do is turn on hidden geometry. Now that's going to let me see all these little lines that we have here. Now, the thing that's important to know, I think this isn't sized correctly to the height, and this can is basically is totally different than what this is. So there's two ways that you can sort of go about this. You can either size this image to the height there, or you can size the length to the circumference. And I'll show you both of those just so you can see the difference. So what I want to do is make sure that this is a group, and then I'm going to scale it. So first, I'm going to measure use the tape measure tool to measure the height of this area. It doesn't have to be exact, so but I'm gonna say this is very close to 9'5½". That's a very large can. So I'm gonna choose this measurement, and it was 9'5.5". Do you wanna resize the active group or component? Yes. So now what I wanna do is just make sure that this is at this starting point here, and the height should be the same. Just double check that my projection is turned off. It's turned on, so I just turned it off really quick. And then over here, now what I'm gonna do is hit B for the paint bucket tool, Alt to select that original texture. And then what I can do is just manually fill in all of these little faces. And what that does is it wraps the texture around for me. But what you'll notice is as I get closer to the end here, it's just gonna kinda keep going forever. Actually, that was okay. But you can see like there's a little bit of clipping here. Oh, that actually happens on that can. This actually turned out pretty well because I made some adjustments to the height of the can or the dimensions of the can, so it worked. But what could happen, depending because the length isn't sized to the circumference of the can, is that you could get like a clipping in the middle of something. But this ended up working, so if I turn off hidden geometry here, that actually looks really good. And actually the only issue that I saw was here, which is actually on the image, so. Yeah, so obviously you can edit this kind of stuff when you get your, like you can edit the image to fix that kind of stuff if you don't really want to resize your component. The other thing that I want to show you that may not be the most intuitive thing because it involves an additional step is that you can choose the length to, like if there's, you can choose the length to size this to. So basically, if there's extra space, like this has a little bit of space at the top that may be okay. To get rid of. So it may be larger than, like taller than this. So what I'm gonna do is first I need to know the circumference. You can obviously use math, but if you don't have to, why? So if I select this and then on the right hand side, you wanna make sure your default tray is open. If it's not, you wanna go to window default tray and this will say show tray. And the thing we're gonna be using in here is entity info. So if I come down to entity info, you can see that having these two lines selected allows me to see this length. So it's just over 17'10½". So if I go back into this, select my tape measure tool, and I want this line to be 17'10.5". Sorry, I rebound one of my keys on my number pad. So that didn't work. 17'10.5". Okay, so that actually just changed it just a little bit, so they're actually really close. But you can then do the same thing we just did by using paint bucket tool and going around it and painting the faces. That's why it actually looks pretty good, because the height and the length are really similar in this particular instance. That's why it didn't tile. It actually looks like it may have tiled somewhere here. That's where it like restarts. You can actually, if I want to cheat a little bit, let's turn hidden geometry on, because this is the only thing. Yeah, I think we might be able to cheat. Texture, position. I can just drag this up a little bit. And I cheated a little bit. Just by positioning that texture a little bit so it looks less weird. You may have to refine it. I fixed it. So there you go. Hopefully this helped. I know this can be a really tough thing to think about in SketchUp, but hopefully this, I've seen a few different videos showing how to do this, but it seems like a lot of them are in like different versions and not all of them do a cylinder. Some of them do like a flat face. So hopefully this is able to really show you exactly what is going on, no matter what you want to apply your texture to. If you have any comments, feel free to ask me in the comment section below. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And don't forget to hit that little bell icon. It helps me get into your newsfeed if that's what you want. So if you want to see more videos like this on SketchUp, just hit that bell icon. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, and as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.